Hi there everyone, welcome back to Infinity Drones, and today we got a great update from DJI. Okay guys, so if you're new to the channel, I do drone videos, DJI videos, tutorials, so I can do some hacks and mods that we can do sometimes as well, and some just plain fun FPV and drone footage. So if you like what I'm doing, please consider to click the like button, subscribe button, and share the videos if you can. Today we can take a look at the latest firmware for the Goggles 3 that adds support for the DJI O3 unit. So what you're going to do is you're going to type in DJI download, and on this section just go to the download center, and once you've opened the download center you can select software and you can see DJI assistant series, and over here we want to go to the consumer drone section. Pick whichever one you want, if you're Mac or Windows. Once you've downloaded it, you can just install it to your PC. Once you install it, it will look like this. Then the next thing you need to do is you need to power on your goggles and then connect the USB-C cable to your goggles. Windows should detect it, and once you see it, you can click on your Goggles 3 and it will automatically check for new firmware. As you can see, there's a new update available for my goggles, and if you click on the release notes, it's going to tell you that it added support for the DJI O3 unit and fixed some known issues. So what we want to do is you're simply just going to click on upgrade firmware. We need to have a solid internet connection, and you're going to click update. Just let it run through the process, and it is going to download the firmware to your machine and then upload it to the goggles and do the flashing completely by itself. Once it's done, we will see if the goggles can connect to my O3 Air unit that I've got here. So let's just give it a minute. Okay, so as you can see, the update is now complete, and my goggles have now been updated so that it supports the O3 Air unit. This does not mean we are done, however, as we still need to update our drone. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to leave my goggles as is. I'm going to leave them on. I'm not going to turn them off. And I'm just going to plug in my drone. Don't need a battery. I just need to plug in the drone and update my O3 unit. Okay, this is a very important part, guys, as this update allows the O3 unit to support the Goggles 3 and the remote controller 3. So we're going to run through the whole process of updating everything. In most cases, your drone is probably going to be running on Crossfire or Express LRS. However, if you've got controller 3, then you can update this as well, and then you can use the S-Bus to make this controller work on that as well. So I'm just going to leave this out here at the point, and I'm going to run the update on my O3 unit as I am running Express LRS over here. If you were using the FPV controller 2 on your O3 Air unit, then simply the settings would be the same. The controller would just be able to bind and it would work exactly the same. So it's a great option to have. So let me just do the update. And the same as before, we're just going to download the update. It's going to transfer and do the update automatically by itself. Now, of course, guys, if you like what I'm doing, please consider to click the like button, subscribe button, share the video with your friends, take a look at the affiliate links below. Everything that you guys do on this video, it really does help out the channel, and I really do appreciate every little bit. Thank you so much. Okay, as you can see, the update is now complete. We can just click back. And you can see that we are now on the latest firmware. So all you need to do now is to unplug the O3, remove the cable. And now we're in a place where we can test if these two can link. I do need to worry about the controller. I'm not going to update it. The process is exactly the same. You guys can figure that out yourselves. But I'm going to quickly just show you that I can link my O3 unit with my Goggles 3, because this is the first time I've updated everything, So everything is as you guys would do it exactly the first time as well. So I'm just going to power up my drone. It's now powered on. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to put it into linking mode because it's currently bound to my goggles too. So you'll see this little bright light over here. What we need to do is we just underneath it, there's a little button. You can see it just turn red. If I press that little red button over there, it's going to start blinking. Which, if you can see, it's blinking in the little video. That means it's in bind mode. And with your goggles, you're just simply going to hold in the power button. And you can see it's now gone into bind mode as well. Once it stops blinking and flashing, you guys are going to see that the goggles is linked with the drone. And it's definitely linked because it's not beeping anymore and everything happened fine. If you take a look in the goggles, it's actually going to tell you to switch to the O3 unit. And if you just click OK, it's automatically going to switch over and you'll be able to link up to this one. So if it just switched over to O3 mode in the goggles, the drone is still in bind mode. However, I need to put the goggles back in bind mode again. I'm just putting in bind mode again. It's going to run and detect the drone. And this time, you're going to see that the light has now turned green. And the reason for that is now I am in O3 mode in the goggles. And this is enabling the goggles to be able to speak to the drone itself. So I'll quickly jump into the menu and just go through the process to show you guys how it works. If you go and press the bind button, a menu is going to pop up to ask you to switch. Then it's going to switch automatically over to O3 mode. And then you can click bind again by holding the button and it's going to go into bind mode again. This is important you guys understand because if you've got an Avata 2, which you obviously have, if you are using an O3 unit, then you're going to have to bind every single time. Flying your Avata 2 again means that I would need to hold the button in the rear of the Avata for. Let me just get the Avata quickly and I'll show you. I would need to hold this button in for 5, 6 seconds to put the drone into bind mode. And then I'm going to hold the power button on the goggles again to put it in the bind mode, and then it's going to go through the linking process again. In your goggles, once again, you're going to get a menu that's going to take you through the process. So let me just show you how it looks in the goggles. Everything from now on, you're going to see in the goggles. So I'm in recording mode now, so I'm just going to go out, switch over to the status menu, and from here I can go up and I can select switch. And as you can see, I'm able to switch to all of the supported models that this goggles now support. If I want to switch over to the Avata, then essentially a little menu is going to pop up, and that menu is going to tell me that I need to go through the process of switching. If I switch over, I need to put the goggles in bind mode, I need to put the Avata in bind mode, and then it will be able to continue. In this case, I have my O3 unit now available, and I can see everything that my little quad can see now as well. So this shows you that everything is now working properly. My little 2S dark star is now overheating, so let me just turn everything off and we can take it from there. So, just to recap, the goggles are now bound to this little quad over here. Perfectly fine. I can fly, I can see everything, everything's good. If I want to fly my Avata again, I will need to press and hold the bind button on the rear until it starts beeping. And once that happens, I will press and hold the power button on the goggles. It will automatically go into scan mode. It will find the Avata. It's going to prompt you in the goggles to switch. If you switch over, it will then prompt you again to bind because it's just switched over to Avata mode, meaning it still needs to go into the bind mode again. However, you could go into the goggle menu and select the Avata 2. It would switch over and then you do the bind mode and then you can do the bind mode on the goggles. But either way, it doesn't make much of a difference which one you go for. It's extremely easy. You just press the button. The only thing that I'm sad about DJI is on the O3 unit, they don't have a physical button. You have to find something. And when you're in the field, finding a paperclip or something small to press in that little hole over there, it can be quite frustrating. Just so you know, you must always switch between the models. So if you're flying O3, then if you switch between one O3 quad and another O3 quad, that's just going to work. It's perfectly fine. But if you're going to switch to something different, like the Avata, or the Mini 3 or Mini 4 or whatever, then unfortunately it's not going to work. In this case, the Goggles 3 supports the Avata 2, it supports the Mini 4, the Air 3, and now the O3 Air Unit. This tells me that pretty soon the Goggles 2 will get support for probably the Mini 4 and the Air 3 as well. In any case, guys, if you like what I'm doing, please consider to click the like button, the subscribe button, take a look at the affiliate links below. If you've got any questions, please put it in the comments below. I would really love to hear your feedback. See you guys in the next one.